Hello and welcome. Excited to be back here together with Dr. Ruth Mary Allen. Welcome, Ruth.
Hi, Donna. It's absolutely great to talk with you again today on Wellness Wednesday.
It is Wellness Wednesday. Absolutely. I'm so thrilled and excited. And we're delighted equally to have you with us. I'm Donna Lawani from Clinical Outreach in the Amen Clinics. And I work with many of our professionals here in the Northeast, Canada, and abroad. And I am joined by the amazing Dr. Ruth Mary Allen, one of the members of our Brain Health Certification Coaching Program from the UK. So we are talking about the ants and what to do about negative thoughts. So what a great topic and pretty timely. How important is that right now, Ruth?
Oh gosh, it's so important, both, you know, for yourselves over in the States and for all those really around the world who, whether you're going through an election or whether you're actually just for us about to go into lockdown or coming out of lockdown and wondering what the future may hold, it's really important that we think about our ants, our automatic negative thoughts, and how they really affect how we show up. So yeah, it's really, really important that we learn how to deal with those.
Yes. And Dr. Daniel Amen, our founder and CEO, had sort of termed this as well out of his own personal experience when working with a patient and coming home and seeing an ant infestation. But at this time, it's rather interesting. He said, he shared during a recent interview that during this pandemic, mental hygiene is just as important as hand washing. It's time to disinfect our thoughts and kill the ants, those automatic negative thoughts, to overcome anxiety, depression, trauma, and grief. So it's kind of fascinating, isn't it, that every time we have a sad or hopeless or angry, unkind, judgmental, or helpless thought, our brain can immediately release chemicals that can make our body feel pretty awful, right? We have this sort of this visceral response from maybe muscle tension, our heartbeat faster, our breath can become shallower, our hands can get cold.
Yeah, and absolutely. And it really affects how we show up. I mean, just for me personally, in terms of thoughts and how that has affected me in the past, physically, you know, back when I was a student, I had an ant infestation in my head, and it started appearing as dandruff in my hair, actually, because of the stress that I put myself under. And it wasn't until I dealt with that infestation and dealt with the subsequent stress that I'd caused myself that I was really able to help myself and heal myself and move forward in life. So it's really important that we recognize the signs, the warning signs of having an infestation in our head, and we listen to what we're saying to ourselves and challenge what we're saying to ourselves. Because as Daniel Amen says, not everything we tell ourselves, everything we think about is true. So we don't have to listen to every stupid thought we have because they're not always sensible.
Absolutely. So. And the negative thoughts too, you know, can affect our brain's activity, right?
So like
you know, or temporal lobes can have a decrease, you know, from this area and also those temporal lobes. So I think it's really important that we understand, you know, how this is, as you shared, affecting our body and mind and you know, so that we can support ourselves for better resiliency. So
absolutely.
Let's talk about things that we can do about this.
So I think the first thing is to really get curious with what you're telling yourself on a daily basis. It is to understand the thoughts that you're having. And a lot of my clients have automatic negative thoughts and don't actually check in with the thoughts that they have in their mind. And they just come to the surface subconsciously and they don't take the time to really think about what they're saying to themselves. So first is to write those thoughts down and get them out on paper so that you can really look at them subjectively, almost as a third party perspective. And that then empowers you to activate your prefrontal cortex and the logical part of your brain and then challenge those thoughts. And that's really the first thing that's most important is to get those thoughts out of your head, stop them ruminating around, and get them out on paper. So you have the power then to challenge those thoughts yourself. So that's really the first one. And then the second is, once you've written them all down on paper, is to ask yourself, firstly, is that thought true? And we know Daniel Amen goes through this process, and it's been he talks about how Byron Katie came up with this really simple, effective approach to challenging your thoughts. So firstly, is it true? And you might say, oh, yes, it is true. But then ask yourself, is it really 100% true? And we may say to ourselves, I'm not good enough is a classic. I'm not good enough. Is it 100% true? No, because you'd be good in a certain area of your life. You may be struggling with a particular aspect of your life at the moment. That doesn't mean you're not good enough. It just means that you may need to learn more. You may need to ask for help. So what is it that you're telling yourself that is not helping you show up as your best self, and that's ruminating around in your head, that's really holding you back? So is it true? Is it 100% true? And normally the second answer is no, it's not 100% true. So find the answers to justify why it's not 100% true, and look for those yourself. Then the third thing is, and this comes back to your emotional resilience that we just talked about at the beginning, is how do you feel when you really have that thought? Because our thoughts drive our emotions. How do you feel? How is that thought making you feel? And then the classic of, I'm not good enough, probably makes you feel pretty rubbish, pretty down in the dumps, maybe pretty hopeless. So it's not actually helping your emotional state, and that emotional state then obviously drives your physical state in your body and all of the associate chemical reactions that we have as a consequence of those thoughts that we're telling ourselves. So how is it really making you feel? And then the fourth is to ask yourself, how would I feel without that thought? How do I feel without it? And typically that feeling is much more positive, it's much more helpful, it's much more hopeful, it's much more driven by logic and perspective. And that is really connecting with the logic part of your brain, your prefrontal cortex, and that really starts to empower you to take back control of these automatic negative thoughts. And then the fifth is to really turn that thought around to its opposite. So what would the opposite be of the thought you're having? So I started with the example is, I'm not good enough. The turnaround would be, I am good enough. And then you go search for the aspects that justify that statement. And then you decide what you need to move yourself forward to feeling even better than good enough, so that you then have that power of control. You're back at the helm of your emotional ship. You have the power back, and you've got control of those thoughts. So those are the real five questions that really help you squash those ants in your head and take back control.
Those are very insightful. And it's absolutely quite powerful to see that the opposite of those negative thoughts are the different brain chemistry. Different chemicals can be released when we do feel happy, hopeful, loving, kind, or have these positive thoughts. So challenging it is so captivating to see how we can turn that around. Our hands right. might get warmer, our breathing may become deeper, our muscles may relax, our blood pressure may decrease, and your brain has the opportunity to work better and perform better. And that's what we're about, you know, performing at our best, feeling that we're optimizing our health and our wellness. And instead of letting things take us along the water out of control.
Right, so, right. And that's so important for our health and well-being these days, particularly, you know, in our current situation in lockdown, a lot of ants are driven by fortune telling, trying to predict the outcome as to what's going to happen, what the future may hold. You know, let's take the election for the, as an example in the States, or when are we going to get out of lockdown? What's, you know, what's that going to look like? And telling ourselves all these negative connotations associated with that. And we don't, we can't predict the future, but we can shape our future by taking action now. And that's what we, that's what we need to focus our attention on, is what we are in control of now, rather than allowing our negative thoughts, the fortune telling ants that are unhelpful to us, to control our mind and to make us feel, as you said, having all these chemicals that are released. Cortisol is a classic, causing us increased level of stress. As we know, cortisol affects our brain cells. It kills memory cells in our hippocampus. And so it's really important that we do take the time to learn how we can squash those ants. And we're not just talking either in this instance about adults. This works for children as well. And I know Daniel Lehman has written a brilliant book on Captain Snout, I think it is, which teaches children how they can challenge their automatic negative thoughts and squash the ants. And my clients have used this, children that I've been coaching, and they find that really helpful too. So challenging the ants isn't just a responsibility for us as adults, but also empowering children, the next generation, to do the same. And as we're seeing that this massive rise in anxiety and depression in the youth population, and it's, you know, it's becoming younger and younger, this rise, particularly, you know, as you know, the increased suicide rate, is making sure that we use these tools that we have in our toolbox to squash the ants, so that we don't get ourselves in a position where we do feel completely hopeless. And empowering children to do the same.
Oh, absolutely. I think that is so important, that this is affecting everyone across different ages and stages in life. And it's broadly applicable in how we can talk back and challenge those ants, and knowing what of the 9 species is impacting them. So I have actually seen a number of adults who have picked up Captain Snout and the Superpower Questions, Don't Let the Ants Steal Your Happiness book, because it does help us as a helpful and useful reminder, look at some of these not negative thought patterns and reverse that. And being aware, especially as Dr. Heyman says, about the 3 worst ant species, the red ants that really stink, the fortune telling, the mind reading, and the blame.
Yeah.
So exactly. They don't have to serve us.
They don't.
There's so
they certainly
many
don't.
Thank you so much, you know, for sharing these insights here today. And obviously, if any of you care about someone who's affected at this time or impacted or is in need of help, whether it be with coaching or consultation, evaluation, we're here for you and you don't have to wait. So please reach out to us. You can check out Ruth's website at drruthmaryallen.com and the amenclinics.com. And for more information, please reach out. We hope you stay safe, healthy, and well, and have a beautiful Wellness Wednesday. Thank you again, Ruth.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.